That's a nice one.
Holy meat.
Kind of a late start this year, but finally getting out to do some rattlesnake hunting. We got the guys inside the house here. We're staying at the Stony Lick Lodge. This is a camp of ours that my parents turned into an Airbnb. So you guys can stay here. You guys can look for it for Stony Lick Lodge in Sinnemahoning, and we're gonna get out and get into the mountains here of central Pennsylvania and see if we could find some rattlesnakes.
Never.
All right, we got the crew here. John Nugent, Luke Sweeney, Brennan, coming back for second year. Gonna try to catch his very first legal rattlesnake.
Hopefully.
Go out and take a quick look at this place. We got a nice big back deck here. We got a fire pit, picnic table. Got a good view of the train trestle down here in Sinnemahoning. Got a good view of the mountains. It's awesome. All right, Brian's ready, and I promised him we wouldn't be climbing any mountains this year.
Except for that one.
So we're only walking in
the
meadows.
Yeah, we're going to be walking in the meadows and
what, that little
in the
guy
prairies.
There?
Yeah, that's hard the easy mount. Stuff.
Perfect so. Tree line.
Yeah. There are two rocks at the top of that hill. We're going to check out here.
That's normally what it's like,
jaunt.
Too.
Yeah, we're going to do a quick jaunt to the top of this mountain.
All right, we're ready to head out. Got a big bear. Big bear. Driving down the road. Standing on the road, now he's gone. So we're walking through the woods here. And just happened to spot whippoorwill. Found it flying away. That's really cool. There was four or five of them laying right here on a branch. I don't know if it'll let me get close to it. Might be able to just reach up and grab it. These guys are all back here. They're too thick to look at them. See if I can get closer to this thing. It's weird that it's just kind of letting me get this close. Oh, there it goes. There, it's flying up.
Oh, yeah.
There, they got to see it. Cool.
There's like five of those, John.
Come on up here. Big rock outcropping. We're gonna look to see if we see any snakes. Okay, we got a rock over here. Getting ready to go underneath. First rattlesnake. I don't know if it's a big one or not. Coming?
He's coming.
He's coming. Keep it going. Yep, keep him going. Keep him going. Keep it going. That's a big snake. Okay, bring him up here. Real easy. That's a nice one. That's going to be a legal snake. Okay, grab him in the middle of the body. Let go of that. Grab
him bring him more in?
Yeah, just grab him in the middle of the body. Now, your goal isn't to pinch him. Don't put a lot of pressure on him. Your goal is just to keep him here. Just keep him out here away. We're going to look for more here real quick.
Can you just hold that for a second? I'm going to get a reboot.
Okay, we're going to look for some more here.
Brandon, that's a male.
Yeah, it does look like a male. We're just going to keep looking around here, see if we see anything. Yeah, do you want to get down in here, John? Right, I think there might be one down there. I'm not sure.
Yeah, I'm going to go right down that hole. We're going to do a little spelunking for snakes.
I'll get down here and see if we see anything.
You see anything on the backside? I'll tell you what, if we walk out here and that snake is legal and you decide to take it, being the color on it is magical.
Yeah, that would make it worth it. That's a beautiful looking snake.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
And he was starting to go under. It's starting to get really hot out in the sun.
Nicely done, yep. Kid.
Come on. So you can see he's not stressing the snake out. So the whole purpose of wanting to handle a snake is to handle it in a way that you're not putting any stress on the snake. You're not trying to pinch the snake. Now, we have a lot of guys that have these types of tongs. If you notice, he's got it wrapped with some tape so that you're not having a lot of the metal touching the snake. and he's not clamping down. The snake is naturally thinning itself out because it feels like it's going through a rock, so they naturally do that. He's not actually hurting the snake this way. You can tell the snake is very docile. It's not striking at us. You can see that he's not even rattling, and he just picked him up. All he's doing is just barely holding him. He's even squeezing through the tongue a little bit, but all he's going to do is just try to hold the snake here while we look for more snakes, and then we'll get a tube on him. We want to show people these rattlesnakes are not out there trying to chase you down and bite you and kill you and all that type of stuff. They're wanting to get away. If he were to let go of that snake, it's going to go under the rock, never strike at him, go probably right between his legs and not care, because he's not trying to, it knows that it's not a threat. It's not even rattling. So we can tell mostly just by looking at it that it's most likely a male, because if you look at the tail, it goes to a long, slender, gradual taper down to the rattle. A female would have a distinct quick drop off right before the tail. So we can almost eliminate that by looks that it is a male. If we could visibly tell that it was a female, we would automatically be letting it go. We wouldn't be tubing it or anything. Now, in the state of Pennsylvania, you're allowed to have one rattlesnake with a permit. That rattlesnake has to be 42 inches or longer. And then we have to find out if it's a male or female. And how do you do that? We'll show you by counting the scales right before the rattle. And the studies have shown that if you have 21 or more of these, what they're called subcaudal scales, it's most likely a male. And so then you can tag it, you can catch it, keep it as a pet if you want to. You can take it, show people, and then release it back into the wild. You can kill it, eat it, get it mounted, eat the snake. You can do pretty much whatever you want after you tag out on a snake. We want to try to take the bigger snake, so this looks like it's going to be over 42 inches, but we're going to take a quick look here for more. So that was a quick talk of the rattlesnake. We'll do a quick scan if there's any more here. So, but it's getting really hot, these snakes. Since they're cold-blooded, they regulate their temperature, so when it gets hot and sunny like this, they usually go into the rocks and they won't come out. They'll come out and back underneath the rock to regulate their temperature. And so let's get a measurement and tube this snake. We have these clear plastic tubes. These clear plastic tubes are fluorescent light tube guards. They're real thin. You can buy them real cheap at like a hardware store. We want to try to get the head up in here. The tricky part is to try to get the snake's head up in here without it getting more upset and trying to strike at you, because they can slip out and they want to thrash around. So you don't want to grab the snake right behind the head or right at the base of the tail. Those are the sensitive parts of the snake And if you start grabbing that snake right there, trying to finagle, it's gonna thrash and it's gonna be striking at you. You don't need that when you're trying to tube a snake. You wanna try to grab the middle of the body, and you just wanna hold it just so that it's moving in place. If it keeps trying to go, you just bring it back and settle it. If you can get that snake's head just started, just a half inch into that tube, most of the time, they think it's a hole to escape from, and they try to zip up in there. The quickest part is trying to grab your hand right here before that snake's head comes out. So you can let go of that snake, grab it down here. And then we're just gonna try, yeah, you just keep bringing him back this way. If he tries to go, you just keep bringing him back. Okay. Let's see. You can let him go here. You can let him go the whole way. Nope. See, he tries to go right up the tube. Easy. All right, now, if you want to hold this snake, grab him right here.
Brandon, turn your hand over. Hold it like
there
he has
go.
It.
There
you
yep, go.
Just like
you don't
that.
Have to squeeze him real hard. Your main thing
Johnny,
is use this hand to put a little bit of pressure up that way. It is, I think it's in the bottom of that. I'm going to have to check.
Take a step that way.
That's, yeah, you
have here, real quick, buddy.
Yeah, I have it way down there.
Get a...
All right, here, we can do a quick show, John.
Here, we'll do the caudal scale count. Okay.
So you have the vent.
From the vent, right here, where the scales change color, you have the caudal scales. You start right here at this bottom one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, and 22 with a split. So I would say that's a male snake, and that's all. And we already 22.
Yeah, 21 is the minimum. Yeah.
Makes it look bigger.
Can you get them all in one frame?
that's definitely.
All right, sit them down. You guys make some shade. So when they're in these tubes in the hot sun, they can get stressed out. So we're gonna make some shade here. We're gonna get this.
Try to get them as, do not move that hand, Brennan.
Yeah, you just
go ahead, let go of this hand and try to straighten them out here in the middle. Oh yeah, this is a doer, for sure.
Well, I saw like 45.
Yeah, it's at 40. It's I would say like
all kinked up. He was at 45.
Yeah.
I'm gonna say
45 because he's got an inch here.
Thumb here.
Yeah. All right. Okay. Now hold him right there. All right. So now the decision is: do you want to keep the snake? You can tag out. He is a legal snake. And you can either let them go, or you can and keep hunting for a bigger rattlesnake, or you can tag them out, keep them. What do you want to do?
Well, I honestly don't know.
Oh.
Well, this is a decision that you'd like.
Yeah,
to
I need
make
to make like now.
Keep them down in the shade.
Because you will not be picking up another snake for
the
day.
The chances.
You can't pick up another snake.
I know like how it was last year.
Here's the thing, we saw a lot of snakes. If he tags out with a rattlesnake, he can still hunt for a copperhead. You're allowed one copperhead. Chances of us finding a copperhead in the part of the state where we're at is very slim. But he will not be able. He can carry tongs. But he will not be able to handle or help touch with a rattlesnake the rest of the hunt.
Yeah, because I know last year we walked him.
We hit a spot where a lot of people usually are. So this is a spot where, but you know, we're going to places where we've never been to, so we don't know if we're even going to see any more snakes. We've never been to this spot. This is a brand new spot. We just kind of thought, hey, let's check out the side of this hillside and found one. So
because like last
it was a very short walk. If you walk more than a mile, you're in the wrong direction.
We did some hiking last year and found nothing. So.
Except for Juneberries.
Yep. We did eat a bunch of those.
If this was you guys, what would you do? Would you keep it or let it go?
Your first snake, 45 inches, beautiful black phase like that.
Yeah.
I would take it.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty then. I'm gonna take it.
Okay.
We have an answer.
You have your pillow sacks?
Yeah, it's in the backpack. All right.
That has some really,
that has really nice coloring on it.
That's a really, really nice snake.
He's got a little bit of yellow. It is a black phase. Now, you hear a lot of this. There's a black phase and a yellow phase. And they have the black phases have black heads, black eyes. And even the yellow phases will have a little bit of a blackish tint towards the base of the tail. But the overall color scheme is black. But this one's nice because it does have little hints of yellow. You can see the pattern very well.
I really like
it's
that.
It's a really nice looking snake. And congrats on your very first rattlesnake.
There you go, Brandon.
Well, thank you, guys.
Part of the club, dude.
Yeah.
Part of the club. The walk was worth it.
Oh, yeah.
The juice was definitely worth it, too.
All right, let's get this bag. You hold it where he's going into the tube. Okay. And then we'll switch this, and I'll show you how to do this since this is your first time. And then I'll grab him from right here. Yep, I got him. Okay.
These are bulletproof pillow sacks, you might ask.
They're all Kevlar, of the highest Walmart quality.
Yeah.
Okay.
I used to sleep on that one when I went camping.
Now what we want to do is we want to try to bring this up here, hold it up here. I'm going to let my hand go here and hold it way up here and then drop him down into the sack. I'm going to go like this, drop him down. Once he's in there.
Move your hand, Brennan.
Yeah. Start turning. And there he is. Now, what we'll do is, you want to grab them and clinch that right there.
And if you're a Billy Bad Butt like Royer, you just throw it underneath your driver's side. You just throw it under your driver's seat.
You just set this underneath your driver's seat, you know, right under your leg on the way home. Now, this is no way something that's protective. I mean, he can still bite. If you were to grab this sack with your hand, he's going to bite right through it like nothing. But normally, they're not striking through this. They're too coiled up to be striking at anything, but that doesn't mean you can go ahead and just grab the sack. Want to act as if we can get bit at any second. So he's got the back part of his backpack, and we're just going to stick him right in there. He'll be fine on the way home. On the way out. Some guys bring buckets and have put buckets on the back. There's different ways that you can do it, but okay.
Okay.
All right. So now he's gonna fill out his permit. This basically tells us what part of the state, the township, all that different types of stuff. The size of the snake, the subcaudal scales, all that type of stuff. And then at the end of the season. You send in a report card to the Fish and Boat Commission. That's who regulates the rattlesnakes, not the Game Commission. It's the Fish and Boat Commission. And then they can use that information to help do studies on the snake and see what type of, how much are being harvested, whether they need to do any changes in the law and stuff like that. So, but, all right. So what do you think? The walk was worth it.
There you go. Giving it back.
It was.
Sweaty.
Oh, yeah.
Great walk.
All right. All right, so we're going to talk about something real quick that Brennan just brought up, because we try to have these discussions before we go snake hunting about the proper ethics of snake hunting. And some of those snake ethics are not squeezing the snake, not grabbing the snake in certain spots, not being rough with the snake, in regards to whether that snake may or may not be legal, you want to release it so it's not injured. And some of that also has to do with, okay, when you're in rocks, you're not trying to flip rocks over to get snakes, okay? But what about a snake that's going under a rock? And what about trying to pull a snake out from under a rock? Now, the general rule of thumb is you don't pull a snake out from under a rock when it's jamming itself up inside the rock, where its belly is against the ground and its back is against the top of the rock, and they kind of wedge themselves and their scales are facing back. So when you try to pull them back, their scales are almost like a Chinese finger trap, you know?
Yeah,
you try to pull it and they just get tighter. And I don't know if you heard me say when you started pulling the snake out, I said, just slowly start pulling the snake, because here's what was gonna happen.
Rip all the scales off.
Well, that, but what I didn't want to happen is if you started getting resistance, I wanted to make sure that you were going to let that snake go. I was going to have you drop it. And so that's something that, with him being a new snake handler and catcher, you have to get some type of experience. And people are going to do things, especially on video, and when somebody's not there and looking at video, they think this isn't right, this is wrong, and stuff like that. But we want to be respectful to those that are getting new into this, and we know that people are going to do things that aren't right. And most of the people who are watching it who are experienced snake hunters have always, at some point in time, have handled a snake wrongly or incorrectly or something like that in the past, and we learn from it. And so it's good to have people around that have good ethics that are trying to help you and to point to you what to do when handling the snake. Now, so that snake was, down in this rock, and from this angle, we don't know how big of a hole that is. We don't know. And so when we get down here and we look, we can actually see that there, it gets really open down there. I don't know if I can see this. Can't tell. Okay, it gets really big and open down there. Okay, and that's what I assumed it was. So when I told you to start pulling that snake out, if I could tell that you were like
struggling,
like he wasn't coming, if he just started slowly pulling the snake and the snake started slowly coming out,
which is what it did.
We showed it on video. There was that snake was not being injured because it wasn't even barely rattling. Then I'm going to keep letting you bring that snake out. If you would have started to pull on that snake
and
it just stopped and you tugged on it and it stopped just to make sure, I would say, okay, let it go. We're not going to try to force the snake out from under the rock. And so that's what we want to try to teach the new hunters. Guys that have been doing it a long time, if you don't know any better from the beginning and you're not taught any other way, you're going to keep doing it. And then that's what happens when you go to some of these places and you see snakes that are all cut up from guys that are reaching back in real tight spots and trying to rip snakes out. That's not what we were doing, and that is not what happened right here. So I wanted to make sure that everybody realized that he did the proper thing, because I told him, just keep pulling. If it keeps coming, just keep pulling it out. And if I would have saw that it would have had resistance, I would have told him, just stop, let it go. We leave that snake go. It doesn't matter how big it is. We'll find another one. We got all day. Because it's not about killing. It's not about tagging. It's about finding snakes, getting to see them, being respectful of them, and showing and teaching others how to be respectful of the snake and show that they're not really a danger to anybody. So hopefully you guys learned something through that. We're going to keep on the hunt. We got a lot of stuff to go through. We got some more rocks down through the woods to look at. And see what else we can find.
Yeah, and I'm glad I got great teachers like Johnny here and the group of guys that I'm with.
If you guys have watched the earlier videos when those guys started hunting, they learned real quick that these things are worthy of our respect. They're nothing to be scared of and try to kill them all.
And we're sitting there handling it right there.
Yep.
Barely was rattling.
Yep.
It'd be nice if there was a little more sun out to them.
Yeah.
But I'll be honest, we're not sweating our cans off down here, so I'm enjoying it.
But if you didn't have any chickens, you wouldn't need to get rid of any eggs.
I just found a really nice snake. See if I can videotape them. Big snake. Big snake. Big snake.
A lot or a big one?
Bat. John, this is your snake. You have to go slow. Come up through. Yeah, don't make as much noise, least amount of making vibrations as you can. It's right on the upper side of this rock. A lot of people think, oh, why are you whispering? You know, the snakes can't hear you. Well, the vibration of your voices has been known to spook. They feel the vibration. You're stepping on stuff, scraping foot on rocks. They feel that and can scurry under the rock real quick. So, get ready. There might be one, there might be two. Get on the upper side of this rock. Hold on, don't move. We need a second person here. Sweeney, you got to come up with John. I think there's two snakes here. Right here in the corner, right past that, this angle where it's cut, they're right below that. And they're right getting ready to go underneath. Don't look at them, because if they see you, they'll probably jump. Okay, John, now. Go now. Get him out of there. That's a good one. That's a fat snake. If you guys want to help. Okay, there was a small yellow in there. Bring him down here.
Holy meat.
Yeah, that's a fat one. All right, let's look around here. Why don't you go over there and start looking for more, and we'll start looking around.
Dude, look at the rattle on that thing.
Oh, he's got a nice rattle,
that's
too.
This is another male snake.
Yeah. Yep.
Hey, are we able to come up?
Not straight up.
So there were two laying right there.
Yeah, Brandon, go ahead. You can walk right up here now.
See if we see any more around here. Sweeney seen this one. Do you need a two-tong?
I will pull it for you.
Buzzed under the rock.
Yeah, he's up under me. Okay. It's a good looking snake too.
Well, maybe he'll come back out. We'll just go over and mess with this one. I used the tongs to do that with. Did not have my hand down there. A male by the shape of his body.
Still wait. Not enough.
Get more, Johnny, get more.
There you go.
That is a whale, Johnny. I'm telling you, that one's big. That's bigger than
sweat.
I'm sorry.
I didn't think sweat is going down my face.
I didn't think yours was legal when I saw it.
That one's undeniable.
24. Close. I lost him there in the middle, but we could try it again.
He's got about, what, 9? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Let's get a tape measure on him. It's definitely a male.
That's a fat snake.
That's a big one.
Hold him up there. Look at that.
Actually, I'll be honest, we should tape it like how he's holding it, because it seems pretty good.
Yeah.
Look at that beast. That's a thick.
I like that stripe down
the back.
That
is a thick snake.
Yeah.
I want to get a measurement on him, because I don't know.
Just hand around him there.
Here, just swing, just measure him like that.
Come on, let's go.
Go ahead. No, I'm not. I will not move this hand.
46 is a really hard way to measure this.
You're at 48 with kinks.
47 at the bottom of the rattle.
I'd say that's 48. 48. He's looking longer the more I look at him.
Man, that's a big snake.
Yeah.
Got a waist measurement.
Gonna say 7.5.
Yeah. 7.5. Pretty much on the nose.
Yeah.
All right, John. Is your weekend done?
$1 million question.
Way better than your last one.
It is.
But this one didn't bite us.
But I have a black one already. What do you guys? You guys want to? So we can cook them, or do you want to put them back?
It's up to you. It's yours.
Yeah, it's yours, buddy.
I think I'm going to put them back.
Okay.
Because I already have a black phase, and I told myself that probably the next black one, I wanted it to be
50
inches.
And this snake is 13 feet.
This snake is pretty close, and this thing's a honker.
Yeah.
But he's going to go back.
Cool. So, just let him go right here. He's fine. He'll find his way. That is a...
Oh, hey, someone pull your iPhone out and take a picture of me with this snake. This thing's a beast, but yeah, we'll put him back.
Yeah.
Johnny. Well, we can always come back to this spot and catch him again.
No.
There he goes. Oh, he landed on a log. He's fine. He's
the log is still on the ground.
Here you go.
It's definitely a quality over quantity log.
It's gonna go underneath the log there. And look, he's already done rattling.
There's his head. He was coming out. Yeah. There he is.
So it just goes to show, rattlesnake isn't all about just tagging out and trying to kill a snake. It's great when you're first hunting, like running, getting your first snake, you have something for memories to hang on the wall and stuff like that. But, you know, you can just over time, just get into just doing catch and release, you know, and just learning about the snakes, taking other people out, showing them and stuff like that. Or you can be really picky on what you keep. You know, there's nothing in the rule books that say when you catch a legal one, you have to tag it. You know, so John can keep going and looking for a bigger one. You never know.
It is super high that now we found. The first two and the only two snakes we found.
Yeah, two snakes, two legal snakes. It's complete opposite last year.
45 and 48.
Last year we found tons of snakes, not a single legal one.
Venom in the tube. Okay, no, it's just dirt. Okay.
Yeah, if there was, it isn't going to hurt if it's inside. Yeah. Okay, cool. It's lunch break time. Fluid time.
That was a hard walk.
Through the woods, tromping through the woods, or up and over the mountains. We figured we'd rather go up and over the mountains. Yeah. Well, these guys were short, so it doesn't help when you go through the brush.
And we're all fat and not skinny.
Yeah. I weigh two of you, so...
I would walk through the hills of West Virginia up and down the gnarliest pipelines in the world before I had to do that all day.
We're coming up on a road. Let's see, we got a live snake or a dead snake?
It's dead, they got flies around it.
Yeah.
Oh man.
That's a female. No, it's not, that's a male.
Freshie? Oh yeah.
That's a male. That sucks.
He's got a nice.
That's a pretty snake, too. Yeah,
get the tape on.
He ain't been dead long.
So one thing, if you are messing with a snake, you always treat every dead snake as if it's still alive, because these things can be like a chicken with their head cut off and still strike at you and run around because they're cold-blooded.
It's right on my toe.
Just pull past it. Yeah. Oh, okay.
You got the raw.
That says.
Yeah. 60. See now? Now move your hand.
Oh, if it's 42, it's 42. It's just barely.
Right, move your foot.
Yeah.
Move your foot and pull through.
Oh, it's not even legal.
No.
41, 41 and a half.
And it's by the straight you're going to get it.
I'll get my tong out here. Green, if you want to go get a set of tongs out of the back of the truck, we'll take it off the road.
I just leave it there.
Okay.
Oh, you want to leave it there?
Yeah. It ain't hurt nothing. It's a shame to see that. Hopefully it was ran over by accident, but it's a shame that there's actually people out there that'll swerve to hit a rattlesnake, and there's really no need, there's no call for it. If this were in the middle of nowhere, there's nobody that's in danger of rattlesnakes crossing the road, so it's really great. There's a lot more people being educated about rattlesnakes, moving them off the road when they're coming. And we just come down this road, so that was just hit here within the past hour or so. What a shame. But, oh well, it happens and you see it. But try our best, try not to run them over. So, all right, off to the next spot. Got some turkeys on the road now. Well, we hit another spot, some spots up on top of a mountain are easy
monsters
to get to. And
everywhere.
We didn't really find too much, so. What time is it?
We found nothing.
2:50, 2:00, 3:00, almost 3 o'clock, and we're done for this day snake hunting, and we're gonna relax, maybe go wade our feet in the creek, cool off, and cook some good food. So
take this all in. All these years of doing this, I've never been dirty.
I know. I'm like dirty
from
walking through
the woods so much. Yeah. So.
Wait. So are we gonna go back?
Look at the dirt line.
He's got a tan line
of dirt.
Of
this is dirt. This isn't tan.
It's not sun. It's dirt. So we're gonna go to the camp first.
Let's go to the camp. Let's gather our stuff for fishing. Let's go fall in a creek somewhere
with some beer.
Drink a couple beverages.
I might just sit in the creek and fish.
Sit down. I might just sit in the creek and not fish.
But it being so low, you might not even. You could probably just scoop them up with your hands. We got this box here. Got them put in the box. He's just gonna sit down here under the shade. Close this up and lock it. He ain't gonna get out. Here we go. Got our snake, pet snake for the weekend. Well, we're gonna go do a little bit of swimming. Yep, this is where we're gonna spend late afternoon just chilling out in the creek, Sinnemahoning. Sit on the back deck, look at the hummingbirds. Pretty good day. Getting dinner ready.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna start off with bacon.
Some light fare.
Yeah. What do we got here, John?
These are, the proper term is venison burgers. I mean, I just call them deer. But these are venison burgers. This is my own, like, created recipe, I guess, if you want to call it that.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. And I'm not shy, so I'll just tell it to you. I do, so it's deer meat cut at McCroot's.
Gotta be at McCroot's.
And it's 80% deer, 20% beef fat. They do, and they're a great processor. I have no issues with them at all. And when I make these burgers, I take 4 pounds of ground meat, and I put, I don't have any measurements.
Yeah.
I just squirt some barbecue sauce and some A1 and some breadcrumbs. I put it in there to a good amount.
Oh, nice.
And for every 4 pounds of deer meat that I make, so if I make 4 pounds of deer meat for burgers or 8 pounds for burgers, I one egg for every 4 pounds.
Huh.
And every time I've made them, everybody loves them, and I'm like, okay, well,
oh,
I guess I'll make
them. They smell awesome.
Well, there's a lot of bacon fat there, bud, so we have a lot of conflicting smells going on right now.
We got all of our food here. Sweeney made the waffle fries.
I feel like we need to take a little bit off the bacon and put it on the fries.
All right, let's eat. Crumble it up. Foggy morning this morning. We're waking up, getting coffee, ready for the day. We got a long hike today. Some blue skies today. Just wait for that fog to burn off. John Nugent had to make sure we got the Jimmy Dean breakfast sandwiches.
Yeah, we had to make sure that we didn't go with the Hot Pockets. Breakfast Hot Pockets are terrible.
Yeah. Luke is up, making our sandwiches for the day. We got all kinds of
these high quality Sam's Club meats.
You would think they would have an easier way to fill them.
Yeah, filling up our hydration packs.
Good morning.
Fog is almost burned off and we're ready to head out. I'm riding with Luke today. All right, well, we've been hunting for what, an hour or so, maybe 2 hours, and haven't found a snake. Went to some really snaky places, a little bit in the woods and stuff, but we're finding nice rocks and where the sunlight's hitting, but just no snakes. So that's just the way it goes. We're hitting new spots, doing some exploring, and that's just the way snake hunting goes sometimes. But we got another spot we're gonna hit today, and that'll probably be it for this weekend and see what else we get into, so. All right, we're at a new spot and I just caught this yellow face. And looking at him right now, I don't think he's gonna be legal. Does he look legal to you guys?
No, he's a fat snake though.
Fat, but
he looks about three.
He was just right on the top of that rock right there. He's got a really nice rattle on him. We're just gonna let him go. First snake of the day. It's noon, he's gonna crawl right back up in there. So all right, so we're in some snaky spots. So that's been a while since I catch a snake, because usually I'm cameraman all the time. But he was ready to zip under a rock, so I wanted to hurry up and bring him out, so at least we got some video. So at least we had video of one snake today, because we were struck out on the first place we were at. So, all right, let's get on the hunt. Sweeney just hollered. Snake scared me, almost stepped on one. Sweeney said it was right underneath that rock. Well, we made it back to the house. Didn't find any more snakes the rest of the hunt, but it's okay, it's getting super hot. We're gonna go swimming, or we're gonna sit in the AC. We're not quite sure what we're gonna do yet, but snake hunting is done for the weekend. All of our snake gear. That's the end of the video. We are done snake hunting, and we decided to stop at the Willows to eat tonight. Guys got lots of wings, food's good. So many good places to eat right here in Sinnemahoning. You got the Swordsman's Club, you got the Tavern, you got the Driftwood Saloon up the road, and you got the Willows. Great place, we love staying here, and till next year, that's the end of snake camp.